on fucking Mars. If the sky's your limit, then you'll never go far. Alright, what's up guys? Poison here. Now, I had to go back to my old $15 microphone. We're gonna talk about what happened real quick. So, if you saw Tuesday's video, you'll know that halfway through the video, I decided to stop talking. I'm like, I'll be back at the end when we try to, when we try to see the stats of the revolvers, and I'm gonna show you the stats right now, but yeah, halfway through that video, my microphone quit on me. I didn't know about this. I just stopped talking, and then halfway, like 5 minutes later, I started talking, and I thought, hey, the microphone's recording. It wasn't. So, upon looking at my footage, my audio is gone. So when I talk about the revolver, it's gone at the end, but we're gonna talk about it right now. I also noticed that when I was doing family bonding with my sister, because we recorded that on Monday also, our audio wasn't recorded at all. Thank God I had my camera recording so I could get audio that way, but it's still unfortunate, so I had to go back to my old microphone. Real quick before I move on with this video, let's move on with stats. This was supposed to be at the end of Tuesday's video. So as you hear, I have the Castigo 44. We're going to compare against each revolver, and if you read the description, I basically talked about what happened, but we'll just say it here again. So as you see, the Bronco 44 has 4 less damage than the Castigo, but it has higher stability, less concealment, and it has a quicker reload by 0.7 seconds. So, you know, the Bronco 44 has a really good reload time, in my opinion, and it has the best reload out of all the revolvers in the game. Plus, look at all these modifications you could put on it. It's not really, like, you know, that necessary to have it. And actually, let's see. But, I see it's basically the same stats, but, oh, wait. Yeah, it just has a quicker reload and less damage. But then if you were to go to the Castigo and look at the Peacemaker, still on par with everything except for the Peacemaker has higher accuracy and stability and a higher threat, but it has a super long reload of almost 8 seconds. That's unbearable. And when you put it against a Matever, still the same thing, except the Matever has a longer reload, less concealment, and more stability and accuracy. So if I had to rate all these revolvers, number one would have to be the Bronco, second to the Castigo, third would be Matever, and the fourth would be the Peacemaker. But I'll be right back when we get to our next part. Alright, so now we're here. Today we're taking a look at the Akimbo Castigo 44 revolvers. So as you see with the mods, they're the same as the normal Castigo. Sorry for that pause, I thought I had to sneeze and I almost did. But along with just the normal Castigo, the Diablo barrel adds 8 accuracy, have no boost on it, I don't really need a boost. And as for grips, I have the Carnival grips instead of the Cruise grips, because I accidentally bought Carnival grips. So, still does the same thing. They add 8 stability, even though it doesn't matter, because Akimbos have negative stability. So, when you add plus 8, it doesn't do much, honestly. But let's move on to stats. The Akimbo Castigo 44s have a magazine of 12, which is technically each time you shoot in real life, the character shoots twice from both guns, or shoots once from both guns. So technically you only have 6 shots, just like a normal Castigo. As base ammo 72, I have 90 thanks to Enforcer skills. Rate of fire 361, damage of 180, I have 189 thanks to some other skills. Accuracy is 76, I have 92. Stability of 4, I have 0, even with the plus 8, but minus 12 because of skills. Concealment of 28, threat of 24, and reload of 3.5, which is 0.5 seconds longer than a normal Castigo. So we're gonna load up a random heist and we're gonna see how these guns do. Alright guys, so I decided First World Bank would be a good heist. There are bulldozers here. And you know, there aren't many snipers, because if sniper comes, it's gonna be all bad with these revolvers. So this heist is gonna be a little bit longer than I wanted it to, but we're gonna be able to put this to a test. Now I did play with the normal Castigo 44s, but I never played with them akimbo, and seriously, this is like, what does it say? He has his name tattooed on his head. Okay. Okay, moving on. I don't even know what to say about this character. So, let's see. We gotta find the usual bank guy. I don't even know, dude. Honestly, I'm trying not to die this video. So, I don't know. I've just had this cough for like a week now, and it's just annoying as all hell, especially when trying to talk. You're not who I'm looking for. Kind of wish these things had lasers, but nope. Let's see. Yeah, it's been honestly a while. The last time I recorded a PayTube video was like 2 weeks ago. That was for my other series where I do the perk deck reviews. And then I saw that this character pack came out, and I'm like, oh, well, I have to do this video now. Because now we have new weapons to try, might as well make a video on it. But akimbos aren't really my thing. I'm not really too into them. I mean, they're cool, they're fun to play around with, but they just don't fit my style. Especially revolvers. Only 12 rounds, it's not really a lot, it's not really going to help out. I'm not sure if I mentioned this in the actual video that came out on Tuesday. So on Tuesday's video, I killed multiple bulldozers, but it takes 5 shots to kill a bulldozer. And the reason I say I'm not sure if this was in the video, because I'm pretty sure I said this after the microphone died on me. Like I said, after this video, I'm going to try to play around with it, see what's wrong with it. Hopefully, you know, it's just the cable has to be put in a certain way. I'm not sure. Like, honestly, you heard it was working in the beginning, then it just stopped working. So I'm really upset. I don't know why that happened, but who knows? Hopefully I can fix it. If not, I'm still going to be buying a microphone later. But for right now, this microphone does good. It does the job. I'm actually going to go grab a cough drop because my throat's killing me. I really just hope I'm not dying. Like, I don't know. I don't know what would cause this cough. Nothing's happened in the past few days that would cause me to be sick, but you just never know. But yeah, revolvers aren't really my thing. Well, the Bronco 44s are my thing, but akimbo, they're not really like necessary to me. I've never once been like, huh, I really wish I had akimbo revolvers. There's a bulldozer now. Oh shit. So if you guys saw that, it took 2 shots and I got his face mask off. You know, technically 1 shot, but technically 2 shots. So let's just say it takes maybe 3 shots to kill a bulldozer entirely. I'm not entirely sure off that. That's not a good test. Because one of these fucking cloakers again got me. We're gonna see another bulldozer down below. But yeah, that first shot took out the face mask. That was actually pretty impressive. One fun thing I would like to see, actually, is akimbo, akimbo 5-7s. That'd be actually really good. But akimbo, judges. That would be OP, but so much fun to see. You gotta think, judges are normally really overpowered anyways, but then playing 2 of them in your hands, yeah, it has to be completely OP, and they got him. Reload time, it's not really that bad. It's kind of comparable to the normal, Castigo. Where's the computer? Up there. Like always. But they're doing pretty good, actually. The only thing I would want to see with them is a laser. But the normal Castigos don't even have a laser, so, you know, I'm just asking for something that's not even on the normal one, so. But they do good. They're actually really good guns. Very powerful. You know, it's kind of cool seeing more guns being added to the game. Now, would I necessarily want a revolver? Not really. I would have preferred more of another rifle, but right now it's actually a pretty cool addition. Really, I don't know. It was just a random addition, too. Like, I've never once heard anyone ask for a cartel character, and then, bam, we got him. Just entirely random addition. But we're gonna have to wait for this. Alright, so yeah, these guns do great work, honestly. Although, I don't know if I'd want to bring akimbos. Honestly, even the single Castigo does really good. So the akimbo's kind of like it's cool to have, but it's not necessary to have type of weapon. I don't know what weapon it compares to. These are the only akimbo revolvers we have in the game, so it's kind of unfortunate. Let's just go fix this. And I'm already out of ammo, wow. Aiming is kind of off. Like, you do have to learn how to aim with akimbos. Like I'm saying, if you had a laser, that'd make everything easier. But unfortunately, with these guns, you don't. So I'm not sure if I said this in the last video either. This character pack, the Sangres character pack, is extremely stereotypical Mexican type thing. I'm actually fairly certain I talked about it in the video, or in my, well, I 100% talked about it in the video, but I'm not sure if I talked about it in the actual video you guys saw, or if it's in the part where my microphone messed up. But honestly, I wouldn't buy this DLC pack if you had to pay for it. I'm sorry, unlike kids in Mexico, I don't look up to the cartel, and having it just as a stereotypical, I'm just gonna say, it's a stereotypical beaner type character, like, it's just not a pack I'd honestly want to own, like, or I wouldn't want to buy. Now, would I buy it? Yes, unfortunately, you know, I do a bunch of PayU2 content, so I'd always want to see what's out there. But, you know, the only good thing I've seen about this so far is just the normal Castigos. The Akimbos, not really drawing me in. Akimbo isn't my style. But a normal revolver by itself does amazing. It's great. It's easy to line up headshots. That's one thing I said that wasn't in the video, because I know that's when my microphone messed up. But with the Castigos, these huge sights, you could easily line it up and get a headshot from far away. I mean, you could even do it with Akimbo, but, you know, when you have the single sight, when you have a single gun, the sights are so open, you could easily look around and see where you're going to land that shot. And that's amazing, honestly. But other than that, haven't played with the new perk deck, haven't played, that's about it. I don't use the machete. I haven't used the machete, actually. I have no reason to be using a machete because a taser just has so much more use than an actual melee weapon. But yeah, honestly, this wouldn't be a DLC I would buy if I had to buy it. Like I just said a minute ago, I would buy it, but I wouldn't really enjoy it. So it took like, what, four shots? Pretty much four shots to kill it. Yeah, but, you know, I don't know. Maybe some people want to play as a cartel member. I really don't, you know. Actually, speaking of cartels, I actually had a lot of fun with a game. I'm not sure if many people know it. I'm pretty sure people did. Call of War is a cartel. That was actually a fun game, and I don't know. You know, like, gang life, cartel life, that's just not something that, like, appeals to me. So, I imagine there are kids who are like, oh, I want to play as a cartel member. It's like, you know, I'd rather play as a Yakuza member, and thankfully we already have Jiro. So this DLC is kind of like, eh, not really that big to me. And like, his voice lines, nah, bro. Nah, I'm good, honestly. But I'm saying, that's just my opinion. And even though these aren't, you know, I wouldn't use these guns that often, they do a lot of great work. Like, if you're someone who wants to play around and have some fun, oh damn, I just got a double kill off that with both revolvers. I'm saying, these guns are a great challenge, and they're actually really good to use. I guess you could say they're on par with the Desert Eagle, but obviously the Desert Eagle has more rounds and higher recoil. Sorry, I had to drink something, my throat just got dry. But, you know, these do add a level of fun because they are revolvers. You only have six shots to make all those six shots count. Actually, three rounds. It took three shots to kill a bulldozer. And like I said also in the beginning, the Castigos only have that plus 4 damage. Or 3.2 damage, whatever. We'll just round up. They have plus 4 more damage than the Bronco. But other than that, the Bronco just seems like the better all-around gun to use. If you want a real challenge, then play with the Peacemaker 45s. Trust me, that's where a real challenge is, especially when you have a reload time of 8 seconds. But these guns aren't bad at all. I'm just saying, you know, they don't fit my playstyle. Which, everyone has a playstyle. Who knows, you might be a submachine gun user only, or a shotgun user only, or sniper, or whatever. If you enjoy a good challenge, then always play around with the Akimbo guns. They're not bad as for challenge, but they're just a different playstyle than what you're usually used to. Like, you can't just run around with a single gun then use both, because this isn't like Killing Floor 2, where every time you click the mouse, you only pull the trigger on one gun. With this game, if you pull the trigger once, both guns get fired. Ah, downed. And we're gonna see if we can burn him. Oh, wow, he just died in one. All right. Fair enough, that was a waste of 3 grenades. But the big upside about this gun that I really like is the sights. The sights are the best thing about this gun, in my opinion. Secondly, this is just more of a personal thing. The guns look like Smith & Wesson 357 revolvers, even though they're chambered in .44, but they just have that Smith & Wesson look that I just really love. I plan on getting a Smith & Wesson, you know, revolver once I'm 21, but that's, like, not really anything for the channel. I'm just saying, like, that's just a huge thing. I don't know. Smith & Wesson revolvers just have that beautiful, unique look that, like, Colt and stuff, they follow, like, a different look. Like, if you know anything about guns, you could instantly tell what a Smith & Wesson is just by looking at the body. And I don't know why, like, I don't know. There probably is a way to tell, you know. I could guarantee you, like, actual gun people know, but to me, I can't tell you, but I just know, like, when I see a Smith & Wesson, I'm like, hey, I instantly recognize that gun. And, you know, that's just a big personal thing that I like about these guns. Honestly, I would like to keep the guns in the stock configuration without the Diablo barrel and without all this, but unfortunately, they do help out with the gun. They just don't help out with aesthetics. So, 3 shots to kill a bulldozer. There we go, you see? Actually, we could kill the other one with this. You see? 6 shots, 2 bulldozers are dead. But that's pretty much on par with also the regular Castigo, you know? Takes 4 shots to kill a dozer. 4 to 6, depends on how much the game likes you or hates you. And honestly, I came into this review, or I wouldn't call this a review, call it an overview. I came into this video thinking, huh, these guns aren't going to be that good. But so far, I haven't had to switch to my secondary. They've been doing really good. They've been doing good with ammo pickup also. That's a huge thing. You know, if you can't pick up a lot of ammo in your gun, you're going to be switching out a lot. But this one, been doing pretty good. Actually, these guns have been doing better than the normal Castigo, actually. Because I remember in the normal Castigo video, I did have to switch out to my primary at one point to get more ammo. But here, no. You're good, honestly. Unless you're, like, trigger happy and you just waste all your ammo. But even if you see poor shot placement, you can still pick up a lot of ammo. And you know, this cough drop is helping a lot, but it's kind of hard to talk with it in your mouth. And I'm not the type of person to do overviews or to do post-commentary either. I'd rather just record a commentary live. But yeah, these just have a 0.5 second reload added than the normal Castigo. And honestly, if you really wanted to, you could rock 2 Castigos at once. You could rock the Akimbo and then the normal Castigo by itself. Let's just go kill the taser. Oh, jeez. I just dropped him. I'm fucking running. You know, I'd rather get tased than cloaked. It's a lot better. Oh, no. No, don't run that way. I don't even know how I dodged the cloaker, but whatever. Whatever. He got caught in the window. And actually, now would be a really good time to switch out to my secondary. It would clear everyone out, but all I'm saying, I'm really surprised that these revolvers were able to make it this far by itself without having the need to switch. I think the only other weapon I've used was my melee and my throwable. That's about it. But easily, just like with the Desert Eagle, one shot will easily kill an enemy. So having the having an option of switching between one shot to two shot would definitely help out. Because honestly, you waste a lot of ammo. If you could shoot one revolver at a time, it would be amazing. You'd save a lot of ammo and you'd be getting perfect kills. But I don't know. Maybe the Overkill did it like this to help like balance it, I guess. I don't really know. I don't talk to Overkill. I'm not even sure if they know who I am, because I have been accused of in the past. Someone said that Overkill sponsors me. No. I do these videos just because I love this game. But we're already running up the time. We're about to be done anyways. And damn well better believe if I'm going to stay here for this whole heist, I'm grabbing everything. And I wouldn't say that these guns make the game easy, because they don't, you know, they really don't, actually. If you don't know how to play with Akimbo, it's just, you know, trouble. But if you get into a clear room, let's say everyone's in a hallway, like, let's say everyone was just packed into here, I could just shoot into the hallway and get, just empty the room. I'm saying, having a sight on this gun would definitely help, but there's not really many sights you could put on a revolver unless you're like Rainbow Six and you decide to put one in the little, where your finger goes. Which would be nice to see, but I don't foresee Overkill doing that. There's really not many mods you could put on a revolver like this, honestly. Like, the Matever, you could easily put an underbarrel one or an underbarrel attachment because it has rails on the bottom. But if you've ever seen the Matever reload, the cylinder actually goes upwards instead of to the side. So you can't put an optic on top, but you can put a rail for an optic on the Bronco. Peacemaker, you're kind of just stuck with a Wild West gun that you can't really do much to, except for like a sniper barrel and a stock. But other than that, there's not many mods. So this gun actually has the least amount of mods for all the revolvers, but still, I would rank it in second place with every other revolver. Bronco's always going to be number one. You know, it's in the base game. You don't need any DLC. Anyone on any console can play with it, and it just works amazingly. And actually, the Bronco is one of the guns that I routinely use, actually. It always takes me out of a tight situation. I believe it takes all six shots to kill a bulldozer, though. I'm not necessarily sure. That's a taser, though. You know, doing these videos always makes me wonder how General McBass does them, because I don't really watch any other Payday 2 players. It's just General McBass, and that's it. Like, I know there's Richard Dangles, and there's a few other people. There used to be Arrow Key Gaming, but he stopped. But yeah, it just makes me wonder, because, like, General McBass, does he do post commentary, or does he do live commentary, or what? Because he always cuts his videos up. Like, always, not really jump cuts, but in a sense, jump cuts. So he'll go from like the weapon screen to like gaming, and his videos sound as if he does post commentary, but when I try doing post commentary, it just doesn't work out. And that's a dozer. No. I didn't want to get hit with the explosion. That's why I ran. I guess we're going to go save him, because why not? We're already at the end. And this is why I bring this little thing, actually. So, first time having to switch out, unfortunately, but that reload would take way too long, and, you know, the Uzi's fully loaded. Why not just use it? No, you fucking stop. You do not fucking move forward. Not gonna lie, I just saw my life flash before my eyes. That was pretty scary. Ooh, you almost just caught a bullet. You just caught a flame. Can I really just not shoot through that? What the hell? But, you know, any statements, the Castigo Akimbos, they do a lot of work. They're really good guns. Like I'm saying, Akimbos aren't really like a challenge because they're bad. It's just, if you don't play around with Akimbo, you're not going to know how to really use them. But The Castigos do pretty good, and they do add a bit of a challenge. You know, you only have 6 shots. But with these 6 shots, you could actually do a lot of work. If I would have got every shot off on his mask, he would be dead by now. But they're not a bad gun at all. Like, I just say challenge in a sense that most people have a secured loadout that they just always use. Like, me, my loadout actually has changed a lot over the years. I used to run the M308 100%, then switched to the Contractor 308. Now I just don't really have anything. Like, I'm always looking for fun new loadouts, and that's why I always routinely play with different guns. It's also why I started doing this series, because it opens up the possibility to play new guns, you know, experiment with what's out there and find out new loadouts. Hell, this gun is honestly my go-to secondary now. Like, and this gun alone could do a lot of work. Especially with its fast reload and its fire rate and everything. Damn recoil. But yeah, we're going to finish up here. I'm actually going to stop talking, and then we'll just go out to our... Actually, no. We'll just do our final thoughts here. Castigo 44, do they have a place in the game? Do they have a place in your loadout? Now, I don't know. I wouldn't recommend these in an actual loadout, like as serious go-to loadouts. I can't imagine doing this on one down, but... For a fun play around with your friends, yeah, dude. This gun definitely could be used. I don't know. Maybe you do use, Akimbos on a regular basis. Maybe they are a part of your actual loadout. If these are a part of your regular loadout, then yes, these could instantly jump up in rank as good revolvers. Now, I'm only speaking about the Akimbo right now, but if you actually want to use the normal Castigo, trust me, the Castigo could be put into any loadout and it'll fit. It's a nice little addition. Damage output, like I'm saying, these sights. You can't see it here, but the sights on the Castigo 44 single, best sights in the whole game, in my opinion. They're really open. You could easily snipe someone from far away. They're not hard to use. And I would love to see more sights like that in the future with other guns, you know. Not like, you know, copies of these type of sights, but just sights that are as open that easily lets you acquire a nice, clean line of sight. Especially if you want to snipe someone. Like, I know plenty of guns have horrible sights. Actually, the SMG-11s have horrible sights. That's why I had to rock a red dot sight on it. I don't like the sights on them. God, what's the name of the gun? What's it called actually in game? Either way, the AUG in the game, I don't remember its actual name because I changed it a long time ago, but the AUG has horrible sights as well. There's just a lot of bad sights in this game, and having sights like this is actually amazing. It's nice to know that they could actually do some good things. Not to say that Overkill does bad things or anything, but I'm saying these guns were a definite plus. I'm happy to have them. I'm just not happy to have the character, honestly. Like I'm saying, I never once wanted a cartel member in the game. Maybe other people did. Maybe it was a huge thing someone wanted. But me personally, I've never played Pay 2 and been like, man, I want a fucking cholo ass bread. Like, I want some fucking drunk Mexican dude to help me with fucking heist, bro. Like, no, I've never been like that. But sights, guns, they're nice. As for the machete, I don't know. I don't plan on ever using it, but Castigo 44 single, amazing. Not the best revolver, but easily number 2 in the revolvers. But the Akimbo definitely blew my mind, honestly. I wasn't expecting it to be as good. So guys, until next time, or until later today, actually, when I have another episode of Quick Play, I'll see you next time. Have an awesome day. Thank you for watching. Bye.